Yes, good morning, everyone.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
So I think we'll start off by talking a little bit about what we done in our last class. So does anybody remember what we did? Motor protection?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do we use to protect motors against short circuits?
Use them.
Fuses and circuit breakers. And we use several different other types of motor protection. Some protect against over voltage and under voltage, and some protect against phase to phase when the power gets out of phase. So anyways, going on to what we're going to do today, I have a short YouTube video, and we have some materials. This is our final unit, SCIM circuits. It's an SCIM being the squirrel cage induction motor. And we'll try to have a Kahoot quiz if we get time. Next week, we're probably going to have a review and a test, and it'll be on the material we covered in the last 3 to 4 weeks. So, any questions or anything in particular you would like to address?
No.
No, not yet.
No? Okay. So we're going to go on to a short video that has to do with the motor control circuits.
This is a three-phase motor control circuit. I'm going to explain how it works. Let's look at the components first. Three-phase motor, contactor switches, overload protective device, relay coil, relay switch to operate the relay coil, start button, stop button. Start button is a push button. Normally, open position. Stop button is also a push button, normally in closed position. Okay, to run the motor, we need to close the contactor switches and the relay switch. How do we do that? If the operator push the start button, current start flowing through the system, energizing the relay coil, which turns the contactor switches close and the relay switch close. Since the relay switch is close, current start continuously running through the system, continuously energize closing these three switches, and the motor start continuously running. How do we stop the motor? For us to stop the motor, we need to open these contactor switches and the relay switch. If the operator presses the stop button, the current stops flowing through the system, which de-energizes the relay coil. As a result, contactor switches opens, relay switch opens, there's no current flowing into the motor, then the motor stops working. So this is how three-phase motor control circuit works. Thank you for watching.
Okay, so that was simple three-phase motor control, and it showed a control circuit and a power circuit. So the power circuit provides the three-phase power to the motor. The control circuit, which normally runs on a lower voltage, will control the motor so that, from an operator from control room, you could use the stop and start buttons to basically remotely start your motor. So, we're going to move on to SCIM circuits. So, the components. So, in order to wire a squirrel cage induction motor, there's three-phase power, many components are required. You need conductors, circuit breakers, overload protectors, contactors, solenoids, and stop and start push buttons. So when they talk about contactors, this is what a contactor would look like. Your three-phase voltage goes in, and there's a coil here at the top. So the coil's energized, pulls down on these switches, and delivers your power to your motor. So, circuit breakers. They're installed on the power lines feeding the motor to protect against the short circuit. If a conductor makes accidental contact with a path to ground or contact with another conductor, the current spikes and the breaker trips over. So look, basically circuit breakers and fuses are the same. They protect against a short circuit and protect your motor. Then we have what's called overload protectors. They're similar to circuit breakers, but they trip when the current is just a little bit too high. So they don't really protect against a short circuit, but if there's a small rise in current, the overloads will protect the motor and stop the power going to it.
Sir? Does the motor should have more than one protector, or only one is enough?
No, each phase has its own protection. So in a three-phase there would be three circuit breakers or three fuses. Okay. And with the overload protectors, they can be set as to how much current would be considered an overload. And if you remember when we looked at motor nameplates on motors, gives a normal running current, and then it gives a maximum current. So that's where an overload protector would come in. You would set it probably to the max current to protect your motor. So contactors, mechanically controlled switches. The switch inside closes or opens depending on the type. So solenoids convert electrical energy into mechanical movement. Motor circuits, solenoids are used to move the contactors between open and closed. The circuit which controls the solenoid is low power while the contactor circuit is high power. Push buttons, either temporarily open or close the circuit. Pushing the button cuts the power and it's called a normally closed button. Pushing the button temporarily connects the circuit, it's called normally open button. Okay, so over the next few slides, we're going to develop the wiring schematic for the power lines feeding an SCIM. So we're going to use common sense, some fundamental electrical knowledge, and a concern for safety. So here we are, three-phase power. Line A, B, and C, going to a motor. So, is Says note, there's no neutral required for AC motors. So you have your power coming in on your three-phase wires. So we're going to need some switches. So basically what's shown here would be conduct. So solenoid operated. And it's going to close the three switches. Then we want to put some protection in there. So we're going to install circuit breaker on each of the phases. And since the circuit breaker only protects against short circuit, we're going to add overloads on each phase. So this is your basically your power circuit. Circuit breakers, contactor with three switches, and overload protection. So turning the three switches off at the same time as the nuisance. So we're going to replace the switches with three contactors controlled by a solenoid. So basically that's your contactors. So that's it. Motor's wired for power, ready to run. Short circuit is protected by three circuit breakers. Too much current draw is protected by three overload protectors. So to turn the motor on and off, all you need to do is connect and disconnect the solenoid from a power source. Okay, so that was the power circuit that we just seen. Now we're gonna do a control circuit. So, as described previous, three-phase motor can be turned on by simply powering the solenoid with electrical current. However, an on-off switch is inconvenient compared to a stop-start button. On-off switch to the solenoid is not as safe as we would like. So, in the interest of convenience and safety...
So, sir, if the solenoid is like missing, would it just stay turned on or off? Oh, it's not going to work like...
Just not going to work. Yeah. So, in the interest of convenience and safety, most motors are controlled with a more complicated circuit than the simple switch to the solenoid. This on-off circuit is called the control circuit, since it controls if the motor is running or stopped. So, let's design one for the power circuit. Okay, so we see our AC power, and we have the control solenoid. So we're going to add stop and start buttons. So notice the start button is normally open, stop button is normally closed. It seems like something goes around. Okay, so notice that the current will flow and activate the solenoid when the start button is pushed. So the start button is pushed, we have a circuit for our power. But as soon as you let off the button, the motor will stop because it will break the circuit. So that's not what we want. So we add in what's called a seal-in circuit. This requires another contactor which is controlled by the same solenoid. So the solenoid here controls this set of contacts here. So now when we press the start button, when we get our power going through here, the control solenoid will close this contact. So when we let off the start button, the circuit continues to run. So remember, when the solenoid is activated, the motor is on, because the solenoid controls the three contactors on the power circuit. So to turn off the motor, all we have to do is press the stop button. The loop is broken and the solenoid deactivates. The motor stays off even when you release the stop button. So, we add feedback from the power circuit. Power circuit turns off from overload. Too much current, we'll automatically turn off control circuit. Using another contactor, this one normally closed. So this is a normally closed contact, and it's controlled by the overloads. So if you get an overload, this would open and stop your motor, stop your power going to your circuit. So that's it. Power circuit and control circuit complete. So this is what your power circuit looks like. Circuit breakers, contactors, and overloads. And this is what your control circuit looks like. So, like I said, the start-stop buttons here would probably be in a control room somewhere so that the motor can be remotely started and stopped.
So, sir, yes. If the motor was working and the solenoid like suddenly stop working.
Mm-hmm.
The motor will shut off or just keep on working?
No, the motor will shut off.
Automatically.
Yeah. Because this set of contacts would open and stop the motor.
And what can be caused of the overload?
What could cause the overload?
Yeah, it's like running with the
yeah, if the motor was, say, hooked up with a pump, and something plugged in the pump, that would probably cause a rise in current, and the overloads would open the circuit and shut the pump down. So the design of the overloads is to protect your motor. So any other questions?
No. Why there's two buttons, like one to stop and stop? Why one isn't enough?
Well, because the one is open and one is closed.
That's always going to be.
Yeah. Okay. All right, how about a Kahoot quiz?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's get the phone out.
How about number?
Okay, so I should see 2, 5, 6, should be 11 people. Thank you.
is.
Everybody's in. Okay. So what is the normal single phase voltage?
Together.
So anyways, 240 volts is the normal voltage you can get for single phase at a plug or receptacle in a catheter. Wasn't a fair question for you, because this is material we're going to cover in the labs next week. But anyways, the line-to-line voltage in three phase is 415. So like I said, that wasn't a fair question for you, since we haven't done the lab yet. So what is the frequency? Single phase voltage. And we measured that in our lab this week, so. That's how four people got it, right? Anyways. So the answer was 50 hertz. Like I said, we measured that in our lab this week. Okay, so three phase power, how many degrees apart are each phase? We'll do more work on that when we get into the last two labs. So there's three phases. Each phase is 120 degrees apart, and they add up to 360 degrees. Color used to identify neutral conductor in single phase power. What's the difference between a fuse and a circuit breaker? breaker can be reused. Basically, it just has to be reset. So you need voltage and circuit. How much do you do it? Measuring current, we're going to be in series with the load. We're measuring voltage, we're going to be in parallel with the load. So power is measured in what? Trips the motor on a small rise in current. Of our bodies is very high. There for safety, directly connected to Earth. Its color is green and yellow, so it ends up being all of the above. Induction motor.
That's hard.
Yeah, we and this this is stuff that's gonna be covered in the lab again next week, so. Last one. Current clamp is a special meter used to measure what? So Amira is our winner. So congratulations, Amira. Okay, so just gonna sort of wrap it up. So we talked about a couple of different things today. Power circuits for the three-phase motor and control circuits. So the control circuit usually operates at a lower voltage and it controls the start and stop of the three-phase motor. Any more questions about that?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Good.
What's the difference between both of them?
Difference between okay, is it the control circuit normally operates on lower voltage?
Yeah.
And the power circuit supplies three-phase power to the motor. So the control circuit would probably have single-phase power going through it, where the power circuit uses three-phase power. And three-phase power would end up being 430 volts. Well, the single-phase power would be 240 volts. Yeah. All right, so like I say, next week we're probably looking at a review and a test. This was the last section we had.
How many labs we have left?
We have two labs left. One is going to talk about four-phase induction motors, three-phase power, and the last lab is going to be on three-phase power and control circuit. So that's sort of a fun lab there. We get to wire up a control circuit and start and stop the motor. Anything else?
So this is going to be Wednesday?
Yes? Yeah, I think it was going to be next Wednesday. Okay. Thank you.